Hey, it's Matt Stepp with Dave Campbell's Texas Football here at the Lone Star Coaches Clinic in College Station, Texas. Here with the head coach of the Dripping Springs Tigers, Coach Galen Zimmerman. Coach, appreciate you taking a few minutes to chat with us.
Oh, appreciate it. Thank you.
All right, first off, a great clinic again this year. The Coach Zerline and his crew have done a great job with the overall putting together a great speaker list. Why is this one of the best clinics to come to?
Well, I think, you know, the format is one of them. They get, like you said, they get great guys to come here. And then the format of how they have it set up, offense and defense, you know, going at the same time. The breakout sessions, and then, you know, this is one of those clinics where you can just grab a coach, and it's either high school or college, and just sit down and talk ball. And so just kind of the setup they have, I think, makes it great for learning.
Have you busted out the napkin and drawn some plays up yet?
Not the napkins yet. You know, you kind of do it in the air sometimes, but you always got your pen handy.
There you go. There you go. Let's look back on last season, and your squad went 9-2 a year ago. You know, another good year. You guys are always in the playoff mix in Austin. When you look back at 2019, what are some of the things you're most proud of with your ball club?
Well, with this group right here, you know, I think we exceeded expectations, you know, not ours, but I think, you know, within our community and everything like
ours.
Well, mine and the players,
yeah.
You know, but they just played. It was a fun group to coach. I think that's what I can say. They really enjoyed being together. They practiced extremely hard. It was just a fun group. And you know, we didn't have a lot of dudes, but we had great high school football players, and it really was the epitome of what you like to see as a team, and so that's why they were successful.
All right, now realignment just happened. Overall, was it what you expected? Talk about your new district a little bit, and kind of what kind of challenges you have to face in 2020.
I think it was really what we expected, other than the Harlandale schools, Harlandale and McCollum coming in. But the rest of them between Austin and San Antonio is kind of where we thought we were going. A little bit familiar. You know, Seguin's been with us for a while. And then we've been playing Canyon and Hayes being in the same, you know, county. So we, you know, we kind of expected it. And some of those guys I know. But it's going to be fun getting to know a few new coaches. And the challenges is just the space, I think. We're going to drive a while. Yeah. I mean, I know people in West Texas don't, you know, they're like, whatever. But
you got traffic to deal with, though.
Yeah.
You got that Central Texas traffic.
But we're excited. You know, it's something new. You know, we kind of seem like we bounce back and forth between going north, going south, and so we're going back south this year.
Now, are your coaches that are in the press box? Does Tiger Stadium still have the best press box spread around?
Yeah, I'm still waiting for you. You guys to come on out and get you some catfish.
Catfish in the press box?
Catfish in the press box, yeah.
Well, I mean, if you get a Thursday game, I mean, I think Tepper, you know, you might get an appearance on television's Greg Tepper.
Well, you know, at a one-school town, Thursday home games are hard to find.
I understand. Yeah, a little tough. We'll make that happen. Final question for you. Looking at your ball club in 2020, still early, off-season, you got to go through the whole off-season. But when you look at what's coming back, what are some areas that you feel good about in your ball club in 2020?
Well, we were a little bit inexperienced this year, and so that was kind of part of it, unsure. But we've got a lot of kids, especially on the offensive side, coming back. So there's a little less unknown. So I really feel good about that. And just the fact that, you know, there's excitement. We've had a great off season. We've got multiple sport kids. So we've had 30 of them in wrestling that'll be coming back. And we've got a bunch in baseball and basketball. So our kids are busy. They're getting better. And they're competing, and so we've had, you know, over 100 out at track practice, so we're just excited because there's excitement for those kids to get better and get back on the field.
Coach, appreciate your time. Congrats on a great 2019. Good luck at 2020.
Appreciate it. Thank you.